Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to discuss the solution of the physics theory paper of the 12th board examination under Assam High Secondary Education Council. So here goes the solution. So in the first part, there were 8 questions, each question of 1 mark, so total 8 marks. So first question is, what is quantization of charge? So quantization of charge is the charge on a body is always an integral multiple of elementary electronic charge. So that is Q is equal to plus minus N, where E is the charge of electron. Why is cyclotron not used to accelerate electrons? Okay. Now for this, you need to write, see, cyclotron frequency, it is given by the expression F is equal to QB by twice pi M. Now, electron being light particle, its mass is very less, it quickly acquires very high velocity. Now at high velocity, the mass will undergo relativistic variation of mass. Okay, so this is the expression showing the relativistic variation of mass. M is equal to m naught divided by square root of 1 minus v square by c square, where m naught is the rest mass. So at high velocity, this m will change. When v is comparable with the value of c, m changes. Now if m changes, the frequency will also change and the resonance condition will not be acquired. So this is the answer you need to write. Next question is, if R and L represents resistance and inductance, what is the dimension of L by R? L by R is called the time constant, so its dimension is T. Okay. Out of the 4 Maxwell equation, which equation establishes the non-existence of magnetic monopole? So this is also a directly textbook based question, that is B dot integral over closed loop B dot dA is equal to 0. Next is, what is the shape of wavefront of light emitted by a long neon bulb placed at finite distance? So since it is a long source, the shape of the wavefront will be cylindrical. Okay. Next is, give the dimension of Planck's constant. So that it is also a direct question. E is equal, from the expression E is equal to h nu, you can calculate the dimension of Planck's constant. What is an alpha particle? So it is a helium nucleus, He24. What is reverse saturation current? Okay, this is a textbook based question. For this, you need to write. So for reverse saturation current, you need to write, for a diode in reverse bias, the current is very small. It is of the order of few microampere and almost a constant with change in bias. That is, if the biasing voltage is changed, the current does not change much. So this is called reverse saturation current. So question number 2, calculate the magnitude of electrostatic force between proton and electron. So this is a direct formula based question. You have to use the Coulomb law. The charges being charge of each proton and electron is 1.6 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Distance is 0.5 angstrom. You have to convert this into meter. Okay, so that is 0.5 into 10 power minus 10 meter. Now along with this, there was a question number 2. There was a choice. A 100 picofarad capacitor is charged by a potential difference of 100 volt. What is the amount of charge stored? What is the electrostatic energy stored in the capacitor? So capacitance is given, potential difference is given, charge stored is Q is equal to C into V. What is the electrostatic energy stored in the capacitor? U is equal to half CV square. So from that you can calculate the energy stored. Next is question number 3. You have an identical cells, each of EMF E, internal resistance R, connected in series. Find the expression for current in the circuit. Okay, this is cells in series. So for cells in series, you may see page number 113, volume 1. In this, the total resistance is R plus NR. The total EMF is NE. So current will be EMF by total resistance. So NE divided by R plus NR. So this is page number 113, volume 1. So along with this, there was an option. Establish the relation for drift velocity. Now this is a textbook based question. You may see page number 98, volume 1. Then question number 4. A copper wire is stretched so as to increase its length by 0.2%. Calculate the percentage change in the resistance of the wire. So the variation in resistance with length is given by the relation R2 by R1 is equal to L2 square by L1 square. Now the percentage change in length is 0.2%. So that is L2 minus L1 divided by L1 into 100 is equal to 0.2. So that gives L2 by L1 is equal to this. So L2 by L1 is 1.002. So if you substitute the value over here, R2 by R1 is 1.004. So percentage change in resistance is R2 minus R1 divided by R1. So I have to subtract minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1. This side minus 1, this side minus 1. So R2 minus R1 by R1 into 100 is equal to 0.4%. So 0.4% will be the increase in resistance. So along with the resistance problem, there was a choice. A 100 watt heater coil is rated 200 volt. Find the resistance of the coil. So power is given, voltage is given, resistance is asked. So you have to use the formula P is equal to V square by R. So from that resistance can be calculated. Question number 5. Show that total energy required to build up current I in an inductor of coefficient of induction L is half Li square. Okay. Now this is a textbook based derivation. See page number 223, volume 1. Then you have find the expression for mutual inductance between a pair of coaxial coils. So consider you have two coils, coaxial coils, C1 and C2. C2 of radius small r, C1 of radius capital R. C1 is carrying current I. Okay. So magnetic field at O, O is a common center. So magnetic field at center O is B1 is equal to mu naught I by twice R. Okay. So magnetic flux linked with this coil C2, it is phi2 is equal to B1 into A2, that is area of C2, this part. So that is mu naught I by twice R into pi R square, because R is the radius of this smaller circle. Okay. So now this mutual inductance is M is equal to phi2 into I. Phi2 is M into I, so M is equal to phi2 by I. So phi2 is this quantity divided by I. So this I is cancels out. So you have mu naught pi R square by twice R. So this is the expression for mutual inductance. M is equal to mu naught pi R square by twice R. So question number 6. A metal rod of length L meter rotates about one end in a vertical plane at right angle to the magnetic meridian. Frequency of revolution is given. Horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field is given. Find the expression of induced EMF. Okay. Now this is similar question is also given in your textbook. The answer is answer to the question in the NCERT problem is E is equal to half B omega L square. For this it is instead of B it is H. So half H omega L square. Now along with this question there was an option. Find the peak current for this circuit. Okay. So peak current is peak EMF divided by impedance. Impedance is square root of this expression. Now EMF is 50 sine 100 t volt. So the standard expression is E is equal to E naught sine omega t. So E naught is the peak EMF. So that is 50 volt. Omega, if you compare, it is 100 radian per second. So if you substitute the value over here, you will get the value of Z. Now if you substitute the value of Z over here, you will get the peak current. So this is how you have to proceed for question number 6. Question number 7. What is power factor of an LCR circuit? Explain on the basis of power factor that an ideal inductor is a wattless component. Okay. So power factor is given by cos phi is equal to R by Z, where Z is equal to square root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C square. Okay. For ideal inductor, this cos phi term is 0. So average power is 0. Since average power is 0, that means the corresponding current is called wattless current. Okay. Wattless current is the current for which the power consumed in a circuit is 0. So there is an option along with this question. Why is electrical energy transmitted at high voltage from distant power generating station? So you may refer to page number 262 of volume 1. See, power loss in transmission line in the form of heat. So this PH is not, P is not power here. It is a power loss in the form of heat. It is given by the expression I square RT. Okay. Now, in order to minimize this power loss in the form of heat, we may think of reducing the value of resistance. Okay. Now, resistance is R equal to rho L by A. Okay. Now, this R cannot be reduced beyond a certain limit. Okay. Why it can't be reduced beyond a certain limit? Because you can't decrease L. Okay. A, if you increase, the cost of installation will increase. If you choose material with low value of resistivity, again the cost of installation will increase. So that means R you cannot decrease beyond a certain value. So to minimize the transmission loss energy, we have to reduce the value of current. Okay. Now power is voltage into current. Okay. So now to minimize this energy loss due to transmission, I has to be reduced. So since power equal to voltage into current, so if power is maintained constant, if current is decreased, voltage will increase, or conversely, if voltage increases, current decreases. So it is for this reason power is sent at very high voltage. Next is, write down the expression for velocity of electromagnetic wave in a medium, and hence find out the expression for refractive index of medium. Question number 8. Now, velocity of electromagnetic wave, it is given by the ratio of E by B. E is the electric field, B is the magnetic field. Now, in vacuum, this velocity in vacuum, that is equal to C, is equal to, this ratio turns out to be 1 by square root of mu naught epsilon naught. In medium, Vm, that is equal to V, is 1 by square root of mu into E. Okay. Now, refractive index N is equal to C by V. Okay. Now, if you substitute the values, we get square root of mu epsilon divided by mu naught epsilon naught. So that gives square root of mu r epsilon r. So this is the final answer. So question number 8, there was an option, what is radiation pressure? So you may refer to page number 277, volume 1, the second last para, the last two lines. Okay. The electromagnetic waves carries energy and momentum. When electromagnetic wave is incident on a surface, there is an exchange of momentum between surface and electromagnetic wave, resulting in a force. This force exerted per unit area is called radiation pressure. Okay, so this is the answer you are supposed to write. Then you have, draw a ray diagram of formation of final image for compound microscope. This is page number 340, volume 2. Then there is option, draw a ray diagram for formation of image by reflecting telescope. Again, this is a textbook based question, page number 342, volume 2. Question number 10. Obtain Bohr's quantization condition on the basis of wave nature of electron. Okay, this is page number 431, volume 2. Then you have, describe in brief the process of gamma radiation, that is the gamma decay, that is given in page number 451, volume 2. Next is question number 11. What percentage of power of amplitude modulated wave is carried by side bands for modulation index? M is equal to 1. Power of the sideband is given by the formula m square divided by 2 plus m square, where m is the modulation index. Now in this question, modulation index m is given to be 1. So that means power of the sideband is 1 divided by 2 plus 1. So that gives 1 by 3. So in terms of percentage, you have to give the answer in terms of percentage. So this 1 by 3 multiplied by 100. So that is 33.3%. So 33.3% is the correct answer. See, for this particular question, the answer given in your few books is wrong. Okay, in some books the answer is given to be 66.6%. So that is not the correct answer. The correct answer is 33.3%. So along with this, there is a choice also, how is critical frequency related to electron density in the ionosphere? Now, critical frequency is defined as the highest frequency of radio wave which sent normally towards a layer of ionosphere gets reflected back to the earth. Okay, now it is related to electron density by the relation F proportional to square root of N, where N is the free electron density. Okay, next is, draw a circuit diagram of potentiometer to compare EMF of two cells. Okay, now this is again a textbook based question, page number 122, volume 1. Next is draw a circuit diagram for potentiometer to determine internal resistance. Again, this is a textbook based question, same page number 122, volume 1. Question number 13. A coil of area this, number of turns n, resistance r, is rotating in a magnetic field with angular speed, maximum power consumed by the coil. Okay, so in this case the peak EMF E naught is n b a omega. So peak power is E naught square by r, so that is n square b square a square omega square by r. So this is the final answer. So question number 13, there was a choice, an AC source of EMF E is equal to 200 sine 100 pi t is connected across an inductor having resistance 100 ohm, self-inductance 2 Henry. Calculate frequency of AC, total impedance of circuit, peak value of the current flowing through the circuit. So this is the EMF given, resistance is given, L is given. Now EMF is E naught sine omega t, E naught is 200. Okay, frequency is omega, if you compare these two equations, omega is 100 pi, so from that frequency is 50 hertz. Okay, total impedance Z is equal to, total impedance is Z is equal to square root of R square plus omega. This is a formula. So from that you can calculate the total impedance. So peak current is I naught equal to E naught by Z. So Z is already calculated. From that you can calculate the value of peak current. Question number 14. Expression for equivalent focal length for lens in contact. Okay, so this is a textbook based question, page number 328 and 329, volume 2. Okay, then along with this there was option, deduce the relation 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F for convex lens producing virtual image. Okay, again this is a textbook based question, page number 326, volume 2. Establish the Brewster's law of polarization of light. Again, this is a textbook based question, that is mu is equal, you have to prove mu is equal to 10 IP, page number 380, volume 2. Along with this there was an option, what is a coherent source, state two difference between interference and diffraction. So coherent source means two or more sources are said to be coherent if they have same wavelength and a zero or constant phase difference. Okay, now regarding difference between interference and diffraction, interference is superposition of light from two coherent sources. Diffraction, it is superposition of light from single slit with different parts of same wavefront. You will have a single source, different parts of the same source will superimpose, giving rise to diffraction. Okay, now in interference all the intensities of maxima are equal. Okay, now in diffraction intensity of maxima gradually decreases as one moves from central maxima to secondary maxima. Question number 16, a monochromatic source of light operating at 200 watt emits 4 into 10 power 20 photons per second. Find the wavelength of light. Planck's constant is given, velocity of light is given. See, similar example is given in page number 396, example 11.1. So, see, power is energy by time, h nu is the energy of one photon, energy of n photons is n into h nu, so power is n h nu by t. Okay. Now, nu is frequency, that is c by lambda. So, that gives lambda is equal to n h c by p t. Then you have, what is de Broglie wavelength of electron in Bohr's orbit of radius 0.51 angstrom in hydrogen atom. So this is again textbook based question. You may refer to equation 12.24, page number 431. You have to use the formula lambda is equal to twice pi r1. Okay. Next question is, derive an expression for radius of first orbit of electron of the hydrogen atom. Okay. Now again this is a textbook based question. You may refer to page number 425, equation 12.15. For question number 17, there was option, from these data you need to calculate which nucleus has greater binding energy per nucleon. Okay, so it is iron 2656, bismuth 83209. Okay, now this is a textbook based question. You may refer to the topic binding energy, question number 13.4, page 462. So question number 18, how is NOT gate realized with the help of a transistor? Give its truth table. Okay, now this solution to this you may find in Concept of Physics, page number 411. Okay, so this is the transistor working as a NOT gate. So this is a NPN transistor. Okay, now this is N, this is P, this is N. Okay, now if the input is low, okay, this is the truth table for NOT gate. For zero it is, output is one, when input is one output is zero. So when the input is zero, this is, see, this is N, this is P, and this is N, this is a NPN transistor. Okay, now if this is N, this is P, and you are giving zero input, that means P is getting a low input. So that means this transistor will be in cutoff state, it will not conduct. Now if it is not conducting, this potential from this battery will be available across X, the output. So when it, the input is zero, output is one. When input is 1, this is N, this is P, this is 1, P is getting 1, high voltage. So this transistor is in active state. Now when transistor is in active state, this potential will be grounded and output will be 0. So this is the action of transistor as a NOT gate. You may refer to page number 411 of Concept of Physics. In question number 18, there is an option, beta of a transistor is 120. What is the change in collector current for 100 microampere change in base current? Draw at least two input characteristics of common emitter mode transistor. So here beta is given to be 120, change in base current is 100 microampere, change in collector current is asked. So beta is change in ratio of change in collector current to change in base current. So that gives change in collector current equal to beta times delta IB. So 120 into 100 microampere. Okay. For input characteristic, this is the graph you are supposed to draw. This is base current, This is base emitter voltage. This is in volt. This is in microampere. So see, 0.6 is the cutoff voltage. So below 0.6 volt, the current is negligibly small, and after cutoff voltage, there is an increase in current. So this is for 10 volt and this is for 20 volt. Next is, what is breakdown voltage of a Zener diode? Explain its use as a voltage regulator. Okay, now this is again a textbook based question. You may refer to page number 486, volume 2. Next is, draw a circuit diagram for a full wave rectifier and explain its working. So there was a choice. This is again textbook based question, page number 483, volume 2. Question number 20. What is digital communication? Mention two advantages of digital communication. So for digital communication definition, you need to write, it is a mode of communication. In this, information is encoded digitally as discrete signals and then electronically transferred to the recipients. Okay. Advantages are digital communication, DC is digital communication. Don't use the short form in examination. Just I have written here to save time. Digital communication can be done over large distances through internet and other things. It is easy to mix signals and data. It is faster, easier and cheaper. Okay. They have not asked disadvantages, but just for the sake of knowledge, you may note down this. Disadvantages are high power consumption and requires more bandwidth as compared to analog signal. So there was a option with in question number 20, what are the side bands of amplitude modulated wave? Compare amplitude modulation and frequency modulation. Okay. Now this is again a textbook based question. Answer to this you may find in page number 525. Okay. Question number 21, define electric dipole and dipole moment. Derive an expression for electric field intensity at a point on the axial line. Okay, this is a direct textbook based question. You may find the answer in page number 27, volume 1. Okay. Now along with this, there was this option, explain the concept of electric field, express electric flux through a surface in terms of electric field intensity, show that electric flux through a cylindrical surface with its axis parallel to uniform electric field is zero. Okay. Now the concept of electric field, you will find in page number 18, volume 1, the last two lines. See, okay, please note down this. For electric field concept, page number 18, volume 1, the last two lines. Okay. Electric flux through a surface in terms of electric field intensity, that is phi is equal to integral E dot ds. For zero electric flux, you may refer to page number 34, volume 1. Question number 22, a charged particle of mass m, charge q, is projected with velocity v, making an angle theta. So this is the question based on the helical motion of charged particle. So for this, you may refer to page number 138, volume 1. Next question is again a textbook based question, two long straight thin current carrying wires. Okay, derive an expression for the force and hence define 1 ampere. So this is again textbook based question, page number 154, volume 1. Question 23, explain Huygens principle of wave optics. Use this principle to prove laws of refraction. So this is again textbook based question. For Huygens principle, see page number 353, 354, volume 2. For verification of laws of refraction, see page number 355. Along with this, there was an option, what is blue shift? So for blue shift, you may write, waves received from a source moving towards observer, there is an apparent decrease in the wavelength. It is called blue shift. This is page number 358, volume 2, the last two lines. Okay. Now along with this, there was a numerical, sodium light of wavelength 5890 traveling from a galaxy is observed at 5896 angstrom. What is the speed of the galaxy? This is an example from your NCRT, example 10.1, page 359, volume 2. So these were the solutions. I hope the answers were clear to you. In case you find difficulty in any of the answers, you may post in the comment box. Hope this video is beneficial to you. Good luck and my best wishes for your board examinations.